Hello everybody, welcome back to Building with Tyler. Today I'm going to take this lovely piece of metal here and I'm going to turn it into a light little sword, and I'm also going to make a sheath for it in this video, or maybe that's, I don't know yet. So I'm just going to have it on my back, so it's going to be a short little sword I can just easily whip out, go all ninja mode without having like a super big katana, because that's what I've already made a katana. It's a bit on the heavy side, it's so hard to swing around. So that's why I'm going to make this one, a simple little light one. And yeah, this should be fun. Right, this is the design of the blade. It is a 1/4 inch thick metal. This wouldn't be a rod, this wouldn't be a plate. What would it be, like a shaft or something? I'm just going to call it a shaft, a metal shaft. I think it is 3/4 inch from there to there, and a 1/4 inch thick, maybe even less. It's super thin, should be super light, and I'm gonna cut it at 25 inches right there. So the handle is going to be out about 6 inches long, because it's not gonna be super big. And then I'm gonna cut a notch in the very, very back here, and then I'm gonna put two sides of a metal rod, twist it around into a circle, and then wrap paracord around it, so it should look pretty cool. And then I have this stretching all the rest of it. Then I think I go back at least three inches, then I loop up to the top, and then I cut it off a tiny bit. Now I'm gonna go cut that out with the angle grinder. Wow, magic. All right, looks pretty good. I'm just gonna have to refine it a lot and take down a lot of material. Now I'm just going to put it on this new belt I got. Look at this. It's the most gritty belt I've ever had. This should sharpen it in like 10 or so minutes. So I'm just gonna put my camera somewhere, take me sharpening and do all that. Should be pretty cool.
I am flesh and I am bone, rise up, ting ting like glitter and gold. I got fire in my soul, rise up, ting ting like glitter. Yeah.
guys. Sword is now done. I'm especially proud of how the handle turned out. The paracord wrap worked absolutely perfectly. And that little egg thingamabob shape then that I made out of wire. That was hard. That was really hard. The other side looks pretty good too. And I think that the sword is mostly done, besides maybe a few like sharpening and polishing stuff. And actually my parents say this is a bit too pointy. So I'm gonna have to dull it, and this is just gonna make me cringe so bad. Just a quick shower of how pointy it is. Right there. Went about that deep, so yeah. Oh, this is gonna make me cringe so bad. Oh, that was painful. It's still plenty sharp though. All right, the sword is mostly done. It's just chilling in that box over there. And now I'm gonna make like this habaki type things, and I can put it in a sheath. This is like a little metal thing that they wraps around just above the handle, so it can like kind of stick into the sheath and not just fly out of it. So I had this old pan. Super thin metal, maybe less than a millimeter thick. Maybe we can just use tape, but I'm gonna try to make this actually good. So I'm just gonna cut this out, see how it works. Okay, I have this piece done. It's just super thin metal. I don't know, I might make like a glove out of this, like an Iron Man glove. It's so light and so easy to cut. I don't know, that might be a new video. But now I'm just gonna put it in the vise and I'm gonna bend it into the shapes I need it to be. Now it's like this. Now I'm just gonna get a spare piece of the metal from the sword and I'm just gonna put it over it. Then I'm gonna hammer it so it's perfectly fitted to that. So I don't have to do it on the sword and like risk damaging it. All right, habaki looks super good. Just custom little piece of metal and it fits perfectly over the steel. And now we're just gonna have to hammer that down and fold it even more over the lid. All right, just got this Gorilla Glue here. And after a while of sanding it down and hammering it out, I glued it on and I think that this is turning out really cool. Okay, the sword is now dry. It's chilling right there. But the habaki looks actually super good. And I was trying to make this sheath for it. And I tried to use like this miller thing and like a piece of wood. And, well, this is the other side. You can say it looks not bad. It's got a few holes in it. Then you flip it over. Oh my gosh. This is not one of my skills. I think I'm just gonna use like a PVC pipe or something. Okay, so I did end up using a PVC pipe. It's super simple, so I don't think I have to like do like a build part on it. This video is getting pretty long anyways, and I'm gonna do a test. So I pretty much just got a PVC pipe, flattened it down only about halfway with the heat gun thing, and then I cinched the bottom off, made the end a little bit, I think it's actually the same width. Now, it perfectly fits over the blade. It's an awesome sheath. All right, so my first plan was to wrap this in kind of like the same paracord I did this, but that would take a lot of paracord, and I actually used all of it on this. That took a lot of paracord. It's probably at least 25 feet. So I think I'm just gonna paint it black, and I might do this. I don't know if I will, but I might turn part of this into like a quiver. So it's kind of like Hawkeye's quiver. I might put it up here, or like some of it. Some of it's like a sword, some of it's arrows. Could be pretty neat. So I'm just gonna paint it black. Okay, surprise, surprise. I did not paint it black. I painted it a cool green color. Just drop that. And it should look even cooler next to the green of the paracord. All right, sheath is done drying. Looks super good. Sword fits in it absolutely perfectly. Now I'm actually gonna take the sword out and we are gonna kind of make little straps for it. All right, so you're just gonna get a little bit of paracord, start it maybe a half inch down from the top, loop it over, focus, there you go, loop it over, and I just had a little bit extra, so I looped it down. Now I'm just gonna get some more rope, and you're just gonna wrap it around the sides over the tapes, and you can't really see it. Heat it up, so it's like a little plasticky thing, and then there you go. All right, so I just got a little bit of like this sports tape stuff, just like tape up wrists and ankles, crumpled it up, attached it to the very end of the string because I didn't have any more paracord, and then I just wrapped it around my chest, and then I tied it on the back, and now works as a perfectly good sheath. Yeah, doesn't fall off. Easy to get the sword out of. Works pretty good. All right, so I have a milk jug full of water here. I'm going to see, can I chop it in half with the sword? Yep. Alright, I'm going to do kind of a fruit ninja thing, and I'm going to try to cut those little two watermelon things in half out of midair. Okay, let's go. That was good. Now let's do the other one. Perfectly in half. Just found a speedy way to pick up all the watermelon. Alright guys, thank you for watching this video. This was super, super fun to make. I'm gonna end it off here. See you guys in the next video.